To install WSL2, search for Turn Windows Features On or Off. Scroll down to Virtual Machine Platform and tick the box. Select the Windows subsystem for Linux, check the box and click OK. Windows Features will prompt you to restart your computer. Click Restart Now. After the computer has rebooted, open Command Prompt with administrator privileges and type in wsl-set-default-version2 to set default version of WSL to WSL2. This must be done before installing any Linux distribution. Type wsl-list-online to see the distributions. Type wsl-install-d Ubuntu to install Ubuntu. This will open another command prompt controlling Ubuntu. Type in a new username and confirm the password you entered. To update the machine, type sudo apt-get update and sudo apt-get upgrade. Hit enter and confirm. Now I install a helper to manage repositories easier. Just type sudo apt install software properties common. This command is needed for some of the Python libraries. Now I'll add a repository. I'll pre-download some libraries to avoid issues that come up while installing Automatic 11.11. This is a long command, so I have put it in the video description. Actually, I put all the commands in the video description. Now, to be sure, I'll install NVIDIA CUDA. After that is done, search the internet for the Automatic 11.11 repo and go onto the GitHub page and choose the stable-diffusion-webui. Scroll down and there will be an installation section. Copy this git clone link and paste it in the WSL2 prompt. Check if it's there with the ls command, and it's there, and navigate into the directory. Now you can launch the web UI. During the installation it may seem like it's doing nothing, but you can check at any time by opening the task manager and checking for the Ethernet utilization, and you see that it's downloading something. After everything is downloaded, you can access the URL by copying it. I'll mark it and then use enter to copy it, and I'll paste it into the browser. You can see it works, I'll just prompt it, and you can see the generation progress. If for some reason it failed somewhere to load a model or something, I recommend you to increase the RAM size. I'll show you how this works. Open up your Windows Explorer and go to the home path directory. Just type that in to a path. And you're on the home path, and I have already set a WSL config file. Just right click and click on new and on text document and call this .wsl config and click on yes. I recommend you to click on view, show and show file name extensions. This way you can see what the file is. And in this case, no file name extension is required. Just right click it and open with Notepad. In square brackets, type WSL2 and then I'll increase the memory size to 5 gigabytes. I have a total of 8 gigabytes of system memory, and I'll increase the swap size to 12 gigabytes. This helps with loading the models. It writes it temporarily to the SSD or the hard disk and loads them back into memory and on the hard drive. And this is how you can set it. And then restart your whole PC and then go into the WSL2 prompt again and just execute the WebUI script again. Now I want to show you two quality of life improvements. One, if you have multiple stable diffusion web UIs like Invoke and Comfy and Flat and Automatic 1111, I want to show you how you can save some disk space. On the Linux file system, go onto Home, on your username, Stable Diffusion Web UI models, and Stable Diffusion, and that's the model you've downloaded. And if you have multiple web UIs, you need to download every model for every web UI, and this takes a lot of disk space, especially if you have multiple. So you can create a link in Linux, so you can actually link to this file to a central location, for example. I'll just demonstrate it. I'll put it onto the desktop and it will copy there, as you can see. I'll close the WSL2 prompt and I'll delete the file from the Linux file system. And now it's on my desktop on the Windows file system. If I launch the WSL2 prompt again, you can navigate to the home directory and I'll create a link with ln-s. And now on the C mount is the Windows file system. So I'll show you how to get the link. Go to your C disk, go to users, your user, and wherever you copied the model. I've copied it to the desktop, but this can also be a remote location like your home server. So that's the path. Just remember user and then your username and then desktop or wherever you copied it. And this path won't work in the WSL2 prompt. You have to type it manually. So I'll just type users, the name, and then desktop. And now the Linux file location, that's at home, your Linux name. And I'll just check it. Home, user, stable diffusion. I'll just copy it here. /, models. Also, I can type that. And stable diffusion. And to create a link, just hit enter. If you put this S at the back of models, of course it will work. And I'll just show you that it actually works. I'll navigate into the stable diffusion directory and launch the web UI. And you will see that it calculates the hash of this model and you can use it like it's literally in your Linux file system. And this is really useful. You can do this for the LoRa's too and for everything else. And now for the second quality of life improvement, you can actually export this WSL file system. So you can give it to your friends, or if something gets messed up by an update or something else, you can just import it. And this is actually really easy. I'll just cancel that and you can go to the Windows command prompt. And then you can type wsl-export and then what you want to export, in this case Ubuntu, and then where you do you want to have it. I'll just copy it to the desktop. I'll give it the name of ubuntu-automatic1111.tar. This tar extension is a compressed file extension. And you can see that it will create this backup here. And it will show no brackets, but when it's finished, it'll just show a new line. After it's done, you can unregister your WSL2. And only do this if you have actually exported. This will delete the Ubuntu. And now you can import the backup with wsl-import. Now tell it where to import it. I'll import it to the local disk, WSL and Ubuntu. So that's wsl/Ubuntu. And now I'll just tell it where to get it from. And it's on my desktop, so I'll just type the path in there. And now it will be extracted to here, and you can see the file size increases. You can store this file on a backup server, or as I said, give it to one of your friends, or in case you need it, if something with your WSL2 machine does not work anymore, you can just import it. I just want to show you that it actually works. You can enter the WSL2 prompt with WSL and you will be root. You can just sudo su into your local user account and then go back into the home directory and into the stable diffusion folder and launch the web UI from there. And this is now running from this location, from this file system. If you have increased the size of the swap file, you will notice in the task manager the read speed will be high because it will read from the disk and it's currently loading the model. And after that's done, it will show, and I've prompted it and it will show the progress here. And you can check your GPU utilization and the images here. So it also works if you have imported WDiffusion from a backup. If you have a question, just ask it in the comments. Bye.